Well, yeah, I mean, ultimately, the state board still is going to have to vote on the tuition increases. And I think we made it very clear, at least some of us did, made it clear to the presidents that if any of them came to the board with a double-digit request, it wasn't going to go far. So I don't think anybody should read into this, that this opens the doors for presidents to come to requesting a double-digit request. It's probably something that we should have done a long time ago because it's kind of arbitrary. I think presidents should have the ability, if they choose, to come to us to ask for any request. That doesn't mean they're going to receive it. We pay these presidents hundreds of thousands of dollars, and so I think we give them the latitude to put together their budgets and to run their universities as they see fit, and then you hold them accountable for the plans they bring before the board, and ultimately the board will have the last say. But I don't have a problem giving the presidents that authority. They probably should have had it a long time ago, but it does not mean that that they're now going to be able to get double-digit tuition increases approved by the board. That's just not going to happen. Yeah, they have to come to us with tuition increase requests every year. And now I guess what we've done is we've removed a provision that prohibited them from coming to us with more than a 10% request. So now they have the right. I don't think it would be wise to do it. I think they know that. I don't have a problem with it being permanent for the reasons I described. I think they should have the authority and the ability to craft a budget that they think is what's best for their school with little or no limitations, because ultimately the board is going to weigh in on the plan that's put before us and will ultimately determine what tuition increases will be. And so, you know, you've got a CEO out here that's making hundreds of thousands of dollars a year. I've never been a fan of handcuffing them in the decisions and the plans, or the plans that they want to put together to present to the board. They're going to be held accountable for the quality of the plan they put together and the reasons they use to justify it. And so I think that alone will keep their requests within reason. For example, before we passed this rule, they had the ability to ask for up to 10%, and they never did, because they had the wisdom and forethought to know what's acceptable and what's not. And I still believe they have that same they'll use that same prudence when they put together their budgets, even though we've removed this one provision.